Good morning. Back out on the tube on the Piccadilly Line today, heading out west to Zone 6. Yes, we're going to Heathrow, but for reasons which will become apparent in a second, I need to start my journey today at a Zone 1 tube station, and so I have come to South Kensington, which is where I will tap in with my oyster as we do episode 11 of End of the Line. So I'm currently on a westbound Piccadilly Line train heading for the Heathrows. If you want the history of this branch, I've previously made a video all about that, which details its construction over the years. I want to say though, the reason why I touched in at South Kensington with an oyster there is because a recent change back in September of 2022, there is no more off-peak fare from Zone 1 to Heathrow. It used to cost £3.50 off-peak, but it went up to £5.50 at all times. But at the same time, they also made a change to the Heathrow free travel area. I once made a Londonist video about that, but it now includes Hatton Cross, and a little known hack which has come into place is that if you're travelling from Zone 1 to Heathrow, or Heathrow to Zone 1, if you get out and tap back in again at Hatton Cross, it costs you less money, which is what I'm going to go and do, and then we'll have an explore around Heathrow. Okay, so this might not work if you've got heavy bags, but if you can, just split your journey at Hatton Cross, tap back in, and then travel the rest of the way to Heathrow for free. Yeah, so that's only cost me £3 something as opposed to £5 something. I'll put the figures on screen. If you're travelling to Heathrow, to or from Zone 1, changing, tap out and tap back in at Hatton Cross will save you money. And it's like a thing they don't advertise. Hatton Cross is now in the free travel area. It makes Hatton Cross feel like it's part of the Heathrow set of stations, which it kind of is. Also, because we're at Hatton Cross, I'll mention, a lot of people think that the lit-up roundels on the platforms at Pimlico Station are the only station where you get those, but Hatton Cross, you get them too. It really mucks up the auto exposure on a camera if you're in auto mode. And there's also these lovely symbols too. And what those lovely symbols are the old BOAC logo. That's the British Overseas Airways Corporation, and it's called Speedbird, and it used to be on aeroplanes until British Airways was privatised in the early 1980s. The bold, colourful streaks of futurism in the tiles look fabulous, and there's a point here at the far western end of the platform where you can get an amazing symmetrical photo with the Speedbird logo right in the middle. One for the Instagrams before you head off to Terminal 4. Train's got to Heathrow Terminal 4. Everyone's getting out with their bags, heading up to the airport terminal. Yes, it's an airport too, not just trains here. You can catch planes as well. But this officially is the end of the line, the proper end of the line here, because the train will now stand here if it's on time for up to 9 minutes. There's a point down there where the driver can go to the toilet, but if the train's running late, they might get less than 9 minutes. But this is where trains sit and stand before they then start their journey back east up towards Cockfosters.
Two other things of note here. The first is this rather splendid embossed 4 in various places along the platform walls. And the other is that had you ever noticed that at all of the Heathrow stations, the gates on the gate lines are always of the wider variant because they assume that everyone is going to have luggage here. And then the train goes around the Heathrow loop. But did you know that there are two emergency exits here, escape shafts for passengers? The first is called Sanctuary Road and is clearly marked on open street maps and is outside of the airport boundary. The second is called Wessex Road Shaft, also marked on open street maps and is well inside the perimeter of the airport. Next time you go for a trip around the Heathrow loop, look out on the left-hand side of the train, and for a split second, you'll be able to see a flash of light and a teeny platform length, which is where trains can stop in an emergency and let people out of the train to the surface. And that brings us around to Heathrow Terminals 1, 2 and 3, except it's not actually called that anymore.
I am at Heathrow Terminals 1, 2 and 3. The roundel says it's 1, 2 and 3. The signage up there says it's 1, 2 and 3. But that is wrong. That is now a lie. Terminal 1 doesn't exist anymore, and all the signage is now out of date and wrong. It is just Terminals 2 and 3. But what was Heathrow Central years ago became 1, 2, 3. It's now just 2 and 3. Please remember that.
And whilst you're admiring incorrect signage, make sure you do also admire a beautiful piece of artwork here. This is Tom Eckersley's enamel artwork and is a stylized image of Concord's tail in overlapping blocks of white, royal blue and yellow. It was commissioned specifically by the London Underground for Heathrow Station, and it's now one of those trendy pieces of artwork that you can buy as a poster at the London Transport Museum.
when I was at Chesham the other day having my flashback memory to 1988 and the newsagents, I had another flashback memory of Heathrow, which is where I knew I was coming next, to a little black on yellow sign that said Chapel. I came here with my friend again just to see what was at Heathrow Airport. I remember seeing a sign that said Chapel. I'm like, why would there be a chapel at Heathrow Airport? And 30, 40 years later, is it still here? Yes, it is.
Step outside the tube station here and there's the bus station. It's a dirty, noisy, bustling area. But yet, keep going, past the bus station, walk down this narrow path, turn left, and then you stumble upon this remarkable place. This is the Chapel of St. George, which provides a haven for reflection for anyone and has been here for over 50 years now. The chapel itself wasn't open on the day I visited, but there is a Garden of Remembrance, and many memorials for people that have worked in the aviation industry over the years are here. If you come to Heathrow for the end of the line, please make sure you do find the garden and enjoy a moment of solitude and reflection.
This is end of the line, literally Heathrow Terminal 5, a station not owned or run by TfL London Underground, actually run, I assume, by the CAA, but probably at least Heathrow Airport. It's run by the airport, not by TfL. And there's only one cool thing you have to do when you come to Terminal 5.
And that thing to do is to go for a free ride on the Heathrow Terminal 5 pods.
With the camera precariously balanced, slightly wobbly. Yeah, if you park at Terminal 5 now, used to be a bus shuttle to take you to the terminal, not anymore. I mean, this has been running for years. There's an old Londonist video I did about it a while back. But if you've still never ridden the Heathrow pods, this is your chance to come and do it. It's completely free. And when we were here before, they said they don't mind people doing it because it acts as an advertisement to encourage people, oh, the bright sun, to come and do it. So if you want to have a free ride to a car park and back from the terminal to a car park and back again, then when you come to Heathrow to explore the end of the lines, like I'm sure you're going to do, follow my footsteps, make sure you get yourself a free ride on a Heathrow pod as well. I say this in every episode. There is a playlist coming up on the end screen right now. This is episode 11 of End of the Line. Go watch the other 10 episodes. I think there'll be about 20 episodes in all, but check out that playlist. Watch them all as I slowly get round and tick off all of the End of the Line stations. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.